students, welcome to this video session. I remain Samuel Chukwu Emeka, aka Sam Dum for Peace. In this video session, we shall discuss the empirical rule that we use in statistics. The empirical rule applies to normal distributions. Okay, the normal distribution or the bell-shaped distribution. So please, it is highly recommended that you have viewed the video on normal distribution, you know, prior to viewing this video. So we have a question here: the heights of the Golden State Warriors basketball players. So I decided to use their name. They have been winning. I mean, they are like the top now. So the heights have a bell-shaped distribution. This is a bell-shaped distribution or a normal distribution with a mean of 175 centimeters. So we have a mean. The mean is 175 cm. And the standard deviation of 7 centimeters. So you are asked to analyze this information using the empirical rule. The empirical rule states that the empirical rule Now we call it the empirical rule, also known as, aka means also known as the 68-95-99.7% rule. Okay, 68-95-99.7 rule. So what does it state? It states that about 68% of the data values lie within one standard deviation from the mean. Okay? About 68% of the data values lie within one standard deviation of the mean. Then about 95% of the data values lie within standard deviations from the mean. Okay, about 95% of the data values lie within two standard deviations from the mean. Then about 99.7% of the data values lie within three standard deviations from the mean. So let's treat this like a sample, you know, let's treat this information like a sample. So in that case, if we treat this as a sample, treat the data set as a sample, treat the data set as a sample. So if we do that, we now have that as, this will be sample mean, this is sample mean, and then this is a sample standard deviation, sample standard deviation, sample standard deviation. So, what is this trying to say? Now, when we say one standard deviation from the mean, okay, lie within one standard deviation from the mean. So we are looking at below the mean and above the mean. That is what we are looking at. So we come one standard deviation, 1S, okay, sample standard deviation, 1S is 7 centimeters. That is what it means. 2 standard deviations is 2 times 7, which is 14 centimeters. That is what it means. 3 standard deviations is 3 times 7, which is 21 centimeters. Okay? Now, when we say one standard deviation from the mean, it could be below the mean and it could be above the mean. Okay, within one standard deviation, from the mean. So this means now 1S from the mean, from the sample mean, means mean minus S and mean plus S. Okay, this is below the mean, and this is above the mean. Okay, this one is below the mean. So we can write this, it could mean below the mean, and then it could mean above the mean. So that is what we are going to try to find out for all of them. So this means mean minus S, one mean minus S, which is what? 175 minus 7. Okay, 175 minus 7. And that gives us what? 168 centimeter. Okay, above the mean means mean, one mean plus S. Because this is still one standard deviation, mean plus S, which is 175 plus 7, which gives us what? 182 centimeter. So what this is saying is that 68% lie, that the heights, 68% of the heights of these basketball players are between 168 centimeter and 182 centimeter. That is the interpretation. At 68%, and I'm going to write it here, okay? This means that 68% of the height, 68% of the basketball players have heights, between 168 centimeter and 182 centimeter. That is what it means. Okay, 68% of the basketball players have heights between 168 centimeter and 182 centimeter. Okay, so we are done with the first one. Now let's do the second one. Two standard deviations from the mean. Two standard deviations from the mean. So what would this be? We have two standard deviations from the mean. From the mean. So below the mean will be the mean minus 2s. And the mean is what? 175 minus 2 times 7, 14. And 5 minus 4 is 1, 7 minus 1 is 6. So 161 centimeter below the mean. Okay? Then 2 above the mean is mean plus 2s, which is 175 plus 14. 5 plus 4 is 9, 7 plus 1 is 8, 189 centimeter. Okay? Now, what is this rule saying? This rule is saying that 95% of the basketball players have heights between 161 centimeter and 189 centimeter. Now, this applies because this is a bell-shaped distribution or normal distribution. So it's telling us that 95% of the basketball players have heights between 161 centimeter and 189 centimeter. And you know, this is for empirical rule, interpretation of standard deviation. I'll write it here. Interpretation. One of the ways you can interpret standard deviation. Please, you need to also view the videos I did on standard deviation. Okay? Interpretation of standard deviation. So that is what this is saying. Alright, let's come to the third one, the third point. Three standard deviations from the mean means mean minus 3 times s below the mean, and then mean plus 2 times s. Mean plus 3 times s above the mean. Okay, so let's write it. So 3 standard deviations from the mean, below the mean will be mean minus 3 times s, which is 175 minus 21. 175 minus 21. So 5 minus 1 is 4, 7 minus 2 is 5, 154 centimeter. Above the mean will be mean plus 3s, which is 175 plus 21. 5 plus 1 is 6, 7 plus 2 is 9, 196 centimeter. Okay? So this will be that 99.7% of the data values lie within 3 standard deviations from the mean. So that the heights of the basketball players are between, that 99.7% of the basketball players have heights between 154 centimeter and 196 centimeter. That is the interpretation. So we see here that 99.7% of the basketball players half height between 154 centimeter and 196 centimeter. That is what it means. Okay, so we have got this done. So now we will not stop here. We are going to now analyze the entire information. We will draw the normal distribution curve and analyze the entire information. So if we have now, let's go ahead. I'm going to kind of erase this. The mean we know is 175 centimeter, and then the standard deviation is 7 centimeter. Okay, and of course we have taken this question because I really want to use this. Okay. Now, we draw the normal distribution curve. Let's kind of let me draw this again. I'm not an artist, I hope you understand. But I'm an engineer anyway, so I should be able. I'm a civil engineer for that matter. So I should be able to do this. Okay. Alright. So we can manage this, right? Now, the normal distribution has the area, you know, the total area under the normal distribution curve is 100%. That is the total area. Now, half of it, 100%, or relative frequency of 1. Now, half of it, of course, at the center you have the mean. So this mean here at the center is 175 centimeter. Okay? The total area is 100%. Then, half of the area is 50%. Now, we have 168, so let's have our 168 here, 168 centimeter, and here we have 182 centimeter. Okay, then we can just, you know, we know that this is centimeter, so let's just remove the centimeter so we have space. So this is 168, this is 182. Then here we have 161. We have 161 here. And here we have 189 here. I'm trying to make sure they have like equal areas. 189 here. Okay. Then we have 154 here. And we have 196 here. Okay? And I know this is kind of not perfect, but we can just use it. Yeah. Centimeter. All right. So, the total area is 100%, or relative frequency of 1. Half of the area is 50%. Now, I'm going to use colored chalk to do this, so it will kind of make more sense. For this one, 68% is between 168 and 182. Between this and this is 68%. Between this From here to here is 68%. This is 68%. Half of it, because of course, the normal distribution curve is symmetrical. Okay, it's symmetrical. Half of it is, this is 34%. This is 34%. I hope you can see this shock, because this whole is 68%. So you divide by 2 because it's symmetrical, and this is 34%. Okay? Then I'll use this shock here. Here, the entire area there, the entire area here from 161 to 189 is 95%. 95%. Okay? So you have 95%. So I want you to look at this, folks. I want you to look at this. You have 68%. You have 95% here. This is 68%. And this is 95%. But my issue is, what will be here? What do you think should be here? Okay? So this part here is your 68%. That part is your 68%. So what is going to be here? So how would you find this? And you know that this is symmetrical. Okay? So you do 95 minus 68. Okay, and let me be fast on this video, so I just use calculator. 95 minus 68 gives us 27, then divide it by 2, it gives you 13.5. Okay, gives you 13.5%. Because you divide by 2, because it's going to be symmetrical. So this is 13.5% here, and this is 13.5% here. So here, we put 13.5%, and here we put 13.5%. Okay? Does that make sense? Because you're doing it, I want to get all these areas. That is my interest. That is analyzing with empirical rule. Okay, this whole is 95%, but I know that from here to here is 68%. So I subtract it, it gives me 27%. And it's symmetrical. I have to now divide it by 2 to get this. So even if you do 13.5% plus 34 plus 34 plus 13.5, it gives you 95%. The next one, the third point, I'm using this. I have from here to here 99.7%. So I'm going to use this here, 99.7%. So you know, this is symmetrical, okay? This is symmetrical. So the same way, I know that from here to here is 95%. I know that, right? So, but I want to get this. So I have to do 99.7 minus 95%. It gives me 4.7%. So this part is 4.7%. They are symmetrical. I divide by 2. So it gives me 2.35%. 2.35%. I come here, I put 2.35%, and this is 2.35%. See that? Okay? Now, the last thing I need this guy. I need from here to here. You know, it's kind of from here to here. Let me use this chalk here. From here to here, this color, I need that. And then from here to here. Okay, now this diagram is not drawn to scale. So take note. not drawn to scale. Not drawn to scale. Not drawn to scale. So I'm just trying to show you, okay? Because if it was drawn to scale, of course, you expect 34% to be bigger, the area, than this. Now, the whole area is 100%. That's the whole area. Half is 50%. So you come here, if you want to find this, and this is symmetrical, just do half, okay? So this is 34 plus 13.5 plus 2.35, 49.85. And of course, if you multiply this by 2, it should give you like 9.7. Okay? 49.85. You now do 50 minus 49.85. And it gives you 0.15. So actually, you have this at 0.15%. And you have this at 0.15%. 0.15%. Okay, so once you have done this, we now do work. Okay, let's now do some work. Let's do some work. So I come here. I will say, if I ask you, how many percent of the basketball players have heights greater than have heights greater than 175? Greater than 175. So if I say greater than 175, of course, it's here. It's 50%. Half of it. Greater than or equal to, please let me put or equal to. Okay? Okay? If I say also, or you can also, if you say, some questions will say greater than, some questions will say greater than or equal to. Even if the person say greater than also, you know, but to be on the safe side, you want to do this. Okay? And if you also want less than or equal to 175, it's 50%. It's from here. Okay? Some textbooks will just say greater than. Some textbooks will say less than. It's 50%. If they say between 168 and 175, you see immediately it is 34%. If they say less than 168, okay, less than 168, you just add this, you add less than 168, 13.5 plus 2.35 plus 0.15. Okay, this is 13.5% plus 2.35% plus 0.15%. Okay, so let's just use greater than here and use less than here. Okay, so this is this gives you 16%. 16%. Less than 168. If I say greater than 189, okay, that will give me 2.35% plus 0.15%. Okay, so this is 2.35 plus 0.15, and that is 2.5%. If I say between 154 and 196, if I say between 154 are 196. Of course, if you look at it, we already know it's going to be 99.7%, because that was what we got. If I said between 161 and 182, if I say between 161 and 182, that gives me 13.5% plus 34%, okay, plus 34%. So this is 68 plus 13.5, okay? And that gives you 81.5%. So once you have this, you can now do anything. If I say less than 154, it is 0.15%. So you can analyze anything they ask you here based on this. Does that make sense? Okay. So thank you so much for listening, students. I really wanted to show you this so that you can understand how it works. Thank you so much, and please watch out for other videos.
And you have a great
evening.